Hello, boys and girls. This week we are starting to talk about legends. So, in this video, I'm just going to give you a quick introduction to what legends are, what the characteristics of legends are, and then a preview of what you're going to be doing this week in writing. So, firstly, what is a legend? Well, a legend is a folk tale that usually has some connection to a real person, event, or a thing. So, maybe it's based on a real person that actually lived on this earth sometime during history. Maybe it's based on a real event that happened, or maybe based on something that actually exists in nature today that we see around us. It also contains many elements that are similar to myths and fables, so you may be very familiar with some legends because of their similarities to different things you've read in the past. We are specifically going to be looking, however, at what are called creation legends, which show how something in our world came to be. So, for example, how a lake came to be formed, or how an animal came to exist, or how some sort of plant came to exist, something like that. Usually it's from nature, something in the world of creation around us. What are some characteristics of a legend? Well, there are several actually, and we're going to be able to spot those in the stories that we're reading, in the legends that we're going to be reading this week. And the first characteristic is that it always has a realistic setting from long ago. Remember, setting isn't just the place where a story takes place, it's also the time when it takes place. So, for a legend to be a legend, it always has to be set on this earth somewhere that actually exists or seems like it exists, and then it has to happen a long time ago. It doesn't have to be necessarily hundreds of years or thousands of years, it can be anywhere in that range, but a long time ago is usually the general time. It also has to have a hero who has positive characteristics, so whatever that means, if they are strong, maybe they're brave, maybe they're intelligent, maybe they're generous, maybe they're caring. Those are all positive characteristics that your hero might have. They also have a problem that the hero of the story has to solve. They have to figure out a way to deal with whatever the problem is and then come up with a plan to overcome that problem. Sometimes that problem can be caused by or made worse by what's called an anti-hero. An anti-hero is kind of like a villain, but it doesn't have to necessarily be what you might consider to generally be a bad guy. Like maybe the anti-hero is just a person or a place or a thing that kind of stands in the way of that hero solving the problem. It just makes the hero's life a little bit more difficult. It doesn't necessarily have to be someone or something that's evil or something like that. So, another characteristic of a legend is that they always have some sort of truth in them about a real thing or a place, whether it's based on a real person that really lived, whether it's based on like a real animal that exists, something real has to be, and it has to be the base of what this legend is about. They also include a lot of elements of cultural life, and that's kind of a confusing phrase, but it basically means elements of a certain culture that you might see around you. So, for instance, Native American legends would have elements of Native American life, things that maybe we don't have in our daily life, but they did long ago when this legend is set. So, for example, maybe it's set in a Native American village. And in that village long ago, the people lived in teepees and hunted bison and used spears to do that. So, in your story, you would have your people living in teepees, and in the story, the people would be hunting for bison and they would be using spears. Are those things that we see people doing today? Not really, but those are elements of that culture. So, that would be something that would be present in the story. Another aspect is that it will always have mystical elements and hyperbole. Hyperbole, remember, is just exaggeration, something that is exaggerated or extreme. Mystical elements basically just means magic. Things are happening in the story that don't really happen in real life, they're magical. And then you have a solution to the problem. The solution is always created by the hero. That's why they're our hero. They figure out how to solve the problem by the end of the story. That's always going to be present in your legend. And finally, there's going to be a lesson that is learned by the characters or by the reader. So we're going to learn something about how to be, maybe the character learns something about themselves or about something else. And in the end, that's what you come away with as a reader. So this week in writing, you'll be doing a few different things. A lot of it is just watching and learning for right now. You're doing a lot of absorbing and looking at different legends. So you're in the research phase of legends right now, getting to know what they look like, sound like, and what they can be broken down into. So first, you're going to watch my video read aloud on the story of Jumping Mouse, and then watch my video lesson on what makes the story of Jumping Mouse a legend. Then you're going to watch a read aloud video of The Legend of the Blue Bonnet and watch my lesson video on what makes The Legend of the Blue Bonnet a legend. And finally, you're going to watch a video read aloud of The Legend of the Indian Paintbrush and then watch my video lesson on what makes The Legend of the Indian Paintbrush a legend. So it's basically like every day you'll get a story, then we'll talk about the story and break it down to see why it's really a legend. And that's pretty much what we're going to do three times. There are three different legends we're going to be looking at this week. And then next week we'll get more into the real writing phase. So a lot of video watching this week. We'll get a little bit more into the writing phase next week. So if you have any questions, please let me know. And I look forward to talking to you guys soon.